What we're doing is we're 3D printing ceramic. It's a clay recipe that's filled with a lot of stuff that's not clay, so that it dries really fast. It's really a lot more like a glaze. The motor is a peristaltic pump, so it works just like your intestines. It's squeezing a little rubber tube. The pattern that's created on the walls is just a symptom of this pump having an inherent break in it. All the code that's coming to the machine to make it operate is coming from Rhino. And I can print about 9 of these in like an 8-hour day. And I need to come in intermittently and fill the hopper with slip. But other than that, the machine can just run operationally on its own. And right now I can print a nest of these parallel walled forms, whereas I can only print one of these that have the more complex curves. I'm actually not drawing the pieces, but instead I'm drawing the paths that the machine takes. So the pieces don't exist in the computer.
How many paths would a piece like this one have in it? Because it looks like hundreds and hundreds.
Each path is 2 millimeters, so I couldn't tell you exactly how many there were there.
What do you think about the relationship right now in craft and technology?
When I think about craft, I just think it's about caring, and I think about just the thoughtfulness of everything from the material to the ground up, all the energy that goes into this, and I don't really create the distinction. It's the same thing. Yeah.